Lord Shiva. As soon as we listen to this name, we not only remember Devi Parvati, River Ganga and Serpent, but also remember a popular name. He is none other than Nandi, the bull. Nandi is Lord Shiva's bull, his vehicle. Wherever Shiva goes, Nandi accompanies the Lord and takes him everywhere. We all know this, but how did Nandi get this special place in Kailasha? To know that, you all should listen to this story. Once upon a time, there was a virtuous sage by name Shilada. He did not have any children of his own. He then decided to worship Lord Shiva to get a special child blessed by him. He prayed immensely and immersed himself for many years in tapas. Pleased by his dedication, Lord Shiva finally appeared before Shilada. He said, "Wake up, dear, and tell me what boon do you seek?" "My dear Lord, I have only one aspiration. I wish to have a child," said Shilada. Shiva smiled and said, "You shall have it soon." Shilada returned home as a happy man, knowing that Lord would bless him with a very good child. The next day, he went to the farm to begin his ploughing. While he found a beautiful baby in the field before his plough. The baby was as bright as sun. Shilada stared at the baby transfixed when he heard the voice from the heaven. "Shilada, take the child. Bring him up well." Shilada brought the baby home and they happily named him Nandi. Nandi was a brilliant boy and learnt everything very fast. Shilada felt very proud of the child. Some years later, two sages, Mitra and Varuna, came to Shilada's home. "Welcome, great sages." Shilada gave the rishis some refreshments. "Please sit and make yourself comfortable." Shilada offered them his home for rest. "Nandi," Shilada called his son. Nandi came in front from inside the house. "Nandi, please make sure these sages are well looked after." Nandi smiled and nodded his head, saying, "Yes, father." Nandi looked after the two sages very well. And after staying there for a couple of days, the sages said, "It's time to leave as they have to continue their journey." Before they left, Shilada and Nandi both sought their blessings. Mitra and Varuna first blessed Shilada. "Have a long and happy life, Shilada. You have made us very happy." When Nandi fell at the feet, the two sages looked slightly sad. Slowly they said, "Be well, son. Be good to your parents and teachers." And they walked off. However, Shilada noticed the change in the expression of sages. He ran outside the house. "Great rishis," he said breathlessly. He turned around and made sure that Nandi was inside the house and could not hear him, and asked the sages, "You looked sad while blessing my son. Is something wrong?" Mitra looked at Shilada with pity. "I cannot wish your son a long life." Shilada was crestfallen. He asked, "What is going to happen to my son?" "Your son does not," Varuna cleared his throat, "does not have a long life. Shilada, I am very sorry to bring this news to you, but that is his fate," he lamely said, looking at the horrified expression of Shilada. Shilada stood there transfixed for a long time. After a long time, he slowly walked back home with stooping shoulders and a broken heart. Nandi immediately guessed something was wrong. "What is this, father? What happened?" Nandi asked, vigorously shaking his father. Slowly and painfully, Shilada narrated his conversation with the two sages. he expected Nandi to be scared or even that Nandi would even start crying. However, Shilada was surprised when he saw Nandi laughing. "You were scared of those sages?" Shilada wondered what could be so funny and looked at his son without any expression. "Father, you have told me that you have seen Lord Shiva," Nandi said with great devotion in his eyes. "Anybody who has seen Lord Shiva cannot be afraid of what the sages said. Father, if it is my fate to die, then Lord Shiva can reverse my fate. He is the most powerful god and can do anything. Do you think he would let anything happen to us when we worship him?" Nandi looked at his father. "I don't think so, father," Nandi said softly. Nandi bowed to his father. "Bless me, father." Shilada blessed his son. "Be victorious, my son." Nandi then went to the river Bhuvana. He entered the river and began his penance. His devotion was so great and his concentration was so high that Lord Shiva appeared in front of him.
"Nandi, open your eyes,"
said the three-eyed god, looking at Nandi. Nandi opened his eyes and before his eyes stood the most beautiful person he had seen in his whole life. Nandi looked amazed. He felt that he had nothing more left to ask. Instantly, a thought came to his mind. "If only I could always stay with Lord Shiva." Shiva looked at Nandi.
"Nandi, your penance was so powerful that it dragged me here. Ask me anything. I will grant it to you," Shiva said.
"Lord, I wish to be with you always."
The words were out of Nandi's mouth before even he could stop them. Shiva smiled.
"Nandi, I have just lost my bull on which I used to travel. Henceforth, you shall have the face of a bull. You shall stay at my home in Kailash. You shall be always the head of all my ganas and you will be my companion, my vehicle and my friend always."
Nandi closed his eyes as tears flowed through them. The Lord had granted him his wish and lot more. Since then, Nandi became Shiva's vehicle. Doorman, his companion and the head of all Shiva's attendants, the Ganas. Thus, by sheer devotion, Nandi was not only able to overcome his fate, he also rewrote it.